Yeah, smart ballgames here. Let's check out TalonSoft's East Front 2. Yeah, as you saw in the intro, which was of course designed for lower resolutions, this game is covering a tactical scale of the beginning of the Eastern Front, yeah, with Operation Barbarossa, up to the attack on Berlin. Yeah, we are currently on Windows 10 11 and it installs and runs pretty good. There's only one recommendation, that you might go into your properties and set 16-bit mode. But even without that 16-bit mode, game appeared to run good. TalonSoft pulled off some piece of software here that is running for eternity, that is good. Yeah, in the main menu we have, you can also play it in a lower resolution, we currently play on HD resolution. This seems to be, what is it, 1024 I guess. It's the default main menu. You can create maps, scenarios. Game comes with a single scenarios, we can check them out. Some scenarios can be played against AI, Hot Seat, PBM. And yeah, I guess this modem, not sure if that is working. To show you the scenario mount. Complexity level describes how much units you might command. It starts with lower units. There is a compilation of this running on the newest engine. I'm not sure, but should be available on Matrix Littering Games. We made a video about it. It is called Campaign Series. John Tiller's Campaign Series, I think. Which includes the Eastern Front content, Western Front content, and the Pacific Front content. And perhaps some bonus content. So that's definitely quite some scenario mount. Complexity is rising. As this game goes from, I think, battalion level up to core level, that is somewhat the scale, but it's definitely tactical. Even if you're on core level, yeah, you will be in command of tactical units a lot. Good, that is this game also offers a campaign mode, and similar to the campaign series which we already checked out. That is rather interesting. You can start a new campaign and you can choose the level. You might play the same scenarios, but depending on the hierarchy, the command level you choose, which as mentioned goes up to core, you might have, I don't know, 200 units under your command. Or if you stick to battalion level, you might have, I don't know, 20 units under your command, depends. But in order to show you the high scale, we will go core. There is, for the Germans, basically up to Kursk. After that, oh wait, there's perhaps more. Ah, there's more. Bagration, okay, I can play also that from German. I was first thinking that you only have the campaigns where the Germans had some sort of initiative. But no. Ah, Winter War is also included. Yeah, that is pre-World War II. Not pre, yeah, but pre-Barbarossa. Yeah, so content-wise, pretty good. And yeah, no, and all those campaigns you can play on those different levels. They design those campaigns basically on core level. But if you choose a lower level, you will receive an outtake of the map, which is a pretty good idea. I don't know any other game, despite John Tiller's campaign series and the successors, we are at Middle East and recently newly received released Vietnam. That applies such a system. So you can decide for on your own. Do you want to be Grognard mode? Command 200 units for 40 turns, spending a month per scenario, or do you want something more streamlined? Yeah, and you can basically design a commander here and then choose us the unit you will be in command. Because we choose a core level, we can select a core level. If you would have chosen a battalion level, we would have to select Panzer Corps, division, and what battalion we're in command of. And then you would be in command of this battalion on a map. You know, that's how the system works. But because we chose the highest level, we are basically in command of the highest formation, which is core. And yeah, campaign mode tracks somewhat your record. That is nice. Good. We are part of Army Group North. And we are ordered to conduct an armored breakthrough. Yeah, Extreme Fog of War is a realism setting, I guess. Armor facing effects, I didn't check the manual, but it sounds rather good. I guess that is how your armor is. But even with deactivate that, it appears to... I was first thinking that is basically meaning that if you get a flank shot on a tank, it will receive different calculations. But I think even without that... Whatever, I will now keep it activated, but it's on default deactivated. Yeah, map is 2D sprite. I think it still looks pretty good nowadays. Watch me. And yeah, the classic Matrix sounds. Ah, okay, the tactical... That's not different. Yeah, and we are not... We can activate the bases here. Yeah. If you want to play a core, you're in command. Jimmy, that is... It's a minimap. Ah, but that was it. So the units don't change. You still command units on platoon level. But if you go core, you will have you will command an entire core of platoons and then and sections, and then you will have quite a lot to attend. If you would now have selected battalion level, yeah, you would receive this outtake. As the map would be limited, you would have a left and right limit of advance. Let's say here and here, and then your limit of advance would be here, and capturing those two objectives, for example. And that is quite an interesting system. I never saw that applied again. So you can decide on your own. If you want to go here full hardcore, playing a scenario like that require a lot of time. It's more than 200. And or you decide to pick a subunit. In order to show you that exactly what it does now here. Alt Q. Good, but what always works is doing that. In order to show quickly, onto it. Let's quickly start a new campaign on battalion level, same campaign, whatever, Panzer Corps. And yeah, now you pick here. I guess they designed a battalion scenario because it requires, of course, some AI modifications. So you can't pick the entire subunit amount of a corps. If you go battalion level, you need to pick a... You might have a choice. Yeah, we, for example, here need to pick that motorized. What was it? Didn't read it completely. And then you have the choice of three battalions. Let's pick the first battalion. Now, a captain that is definitely not battalion level. But in, I mean, in desperate times, also a captain might command a battalion. First, you first need to advance. Normally, it would be something like, it would be a staff officer level, something like Oberstleutnant, which would be in command of a battalion. Captain, yeah, that is the lowest tier of officers. Hauptmann, on German, that would be in command of a company. Yeah? But whatever, yeah. Sometimes in war it happened that a captain might be in command of a higher echelon. Absolutely fine. I'm not sure if those missions are randomly generated or if they change with if you apply a different echelon. But in order to show it to you, now you have still quite a lot of units. But it's not 1 million units, yeah? Now you have something like, I don't know, what is that, 30 units? About. Everything on platoon level, yeah, battalion, what is it, yeah, it is... Let's say three, four platoons per company. Plus... Yeah, the same amount. Depends, yeah, there's also reinforced battalions, which roll more companies. But that's how it works, yeah. And then you give right here, I mean, setup phase. And roll. Great in this game is that you simply pick a direction and it is hex based. You can also activate hexes. But those games made sure that they play like tabletop games. Yeah? Especially if you activate bases, you really get this tabletop feeling. And I must say, on this scale, there's really not much games that recreated this experience. Very good controls, you pick a destination. No matter if that unit can reach it or not, it will pick the best path. So there's no micromanagement, also reaction fire. Probably AT guns. Yeah, 76 this 3 AT guns firing on our Panzer 3 Friedrich. Don't think we can respond now because we're out of action points. Trucks having infantry loaded. Let's get those guys close here in the tree line. But I wanted to play not this scenario. That was only for me to show you how this game scales. Yeah, because I want to play a single player scenario. this Jimmy. Everybody likes King Tigers, yeah? Not King Tigers, Tigers, yeah? Good. We want to play the Claw of the Tiger, 10 turns. It is 43. January. I think that was the first introduction of the King Tiger, not King Tiger, regular Tiger. Panzerkampfwagen 6. Mass introduction was, of course, when Operation Citadelle happened, yeah, Kursk. But Germans indeed already in the winter and in Africa tested those King Tiger, Jimmy, why I'm on King Tiger? Tigers. With rather mixed results. The first Tiger actions on the East Front, those experimental Tiger actions were rather not that great, but that is often to be expected if you deploy a new tank prototype onto the front. Wait, yeah, January 43. Kursk was July 43. So we have an incursion of Soviet tank forces consisting of the 122nd Tank Brigade. In this scenario is a version of Squad Leader's The Paw of the Tiger. Yeah, that's great. So if you're a Squad Leader fan, check that out. As you will see action here of the 1st Company 502nd Tiger Battalion. I guess later it was renamed to Heavy Tank Battalion. Or Heavy Tank Abteilung, that is something like detachment. Yeah, I guess that was probably one of the first actions of the Tiger on the Eastern Front before Kursk. And this scenario sounds quite interesting and I want to play it from the German side. Rules, let's deactivate that. I can't activate the help because it is not supported by modern Windows anymore. Armor facing effects. But normally it sounds quite realistic, but why should the developers keep it deactivated on default? Again, I played some sessions and I noticed that if you flank short tanks, they will blow up more likely than frontal shot. So I'm not exactly sure what this armor facing effect is. Let's roll. So let's first check the map. Jimmy, what? We heard some tank sounds, but no contact so far. Is that correct? It's a mini map we can activate. We are red. So I guess the Allied or the Soviets are blue. Is that? Good. We definitely heard some tank sounds. At least for me, it sounded like some track sounds. Let's activate bases because it is sometimes difficult to see units. Yeah, we hear sounds, but we have no visual. We have, what is that? Rifle platoon sitting here in the tree line, observing. Then we have another rifle platoon. Rifle platoon. 75mm puck. Sonder KFZ 11. Is that AT? I can't tell.
Sonder KFZ 11.
I'm not exactly sure what a Sonder KFZ 11 is. Do we want to retreat it? Is it only equipped with a MG system? Or because certain Sonder KFZ half tracks were equipped with anti-tank guns. Usually with rather not that impressive weapons like a 38 Mike. But very seldom they were also equipped with a 75 Mike pack. But I guess that is not the case here, otherwise the icon would look different. So considering that we hear armored vehicles, let's rather retreat those half tracks. .50 Mike AT, yeah. It's not impressive, but okay. Machine gun. Another Sonder KFZ 11. Because I don't want those half tracks to pop up. Waggons. What is that meaning? Waggons. Supply. But where's my Tigers? Yeah, those Tigers might arrive later. I found my Tigers. Okay. A Tiger. Oh, wait.
We have Panzer 6 Erich.
That is definitely a Tiger. Then we have a Hauptmann Bolter riding in a Kübelwagen. Another Tiger 6. Yeah, regular Tiger. And a Panzerkampfwagen 4. Friedrich 2. So we have basically two Tigers. Yeah, that's good. Jimmy, roll up here. Those Tigers should stop what might. Yeah, the Soviets might apply T-34s. And another Tiger we apply. Show me the map. This point. And okay, Tigers. Captain Hauptmann Bolter. Establish a Gefechtsstand hier. And the Panzerkampfwagen V4 we will keep in reserve here. Okay, so we have already two Tigers on the scene. And currently no contact to enemy. Let's end the turn. heroes. So, still no Soviets. Doesn't look like.
Yo.
Okay. Nevertheless, we'll continue the plan. This tiger is moving up. Say, if we meet here, main opposition. The tiger. It's moving up the rail. That is also a tiger, yeah. No, that is a Panzerkampfwagen 4. That is a second tiger. Oh yeah, we set this crossroads here. Panzerkampfwagen 4. We designated to be a reserve here. Which also means Command, Hauptmann, Bolter can also roll here. Gee, what the heck? It's French. Good. No enemy contact so far, but we hear sounds. Yeah, we hear sounds of what appears to be tracked vehicles. Why you are sitting? Ah, that is trees. Machine gun platoon together with disperse a bit. We have armored threat. Let's get the half tracks out of action. Oh! T-34 platoon. Rolling in hard. Jim, what is that? This Sonderkfz. Oh! What is that? Trucks, mech infantry rolling in, okay. Are those tanks going crazy? Okay. More tanks, another tank platoon coming up. Can we fire on him? Is that, okay, I don't go there. Okay. Tank platoon here, one mech platoon. But we can't fire on them because that position is blocking. If we want to go into that position. Okay, yeah, stay there. Let them come. Then we have. That those guys rolling into our flank. Tiger is coming up. Perhaps from that tree line. We can engage them. What's the problem? Not enough action points. Damn it. Good, stay here. Infantry close assault and not viable right now. Stay put. Can we roll in that mech infantry? We could send a survival platoon to the tree line in order to engage them. Let's do that. Tank reaction fire. Okay, that's a bit too dangerous. Seeing quite a lot of fire here. But anyways, attack. Okay. Managed to retreat some infantry platoon. That's it. Yeah, we have a Panzer IV in reserve, which I don't want to commit right now. Oh, Tony's popping up on Tiger. We might play more of this, of those classic war games, because they roll a lower scale, which is really sometimes hard to find in modern war games. Reaction fire caused them to retreat. Tigers, engage. Yeah, because we moved out the tiger probably doesn't have enough action points to react. Something explored here. Probably infantry caused some casualties. We might go close assault on those tanks. They're in the woods, they're vulnerable. Good. Rifle platoon, mobilize, maneuver, engage enemy armor in close assault means. You are instructed, prepared. Do we want to add? I don't know, can those guys reach? Seems like. Resolve the close assault. Wait, what do we have else here? Rifle platoon. Machine gun, yeah. Let's keep those machine guns. Let's don't let the machine guns participate. They are not really tank hunters. Yeah. Tanks destroyed, T-34s eliminated. Good job. Oh, sorry. Yeah, Tiger is in close contact here with T-34s. Which also, we could retreat the Tiger, because the Tiger is not impenetrable. Yeah. A T-34 might hit a sweet spot and destroy the Tiger, or might render it combat ineffective. I mean, the Tiger is all aspect armored, because it was designed as a breakthrough tank. But we will maintain a position and engage. We have 4 7 T-34s advancing here. We have three Tigers. Be enough. Engage. Okay, a T-34 group is retreating. That appeared to be a miss. So read that. Impressive. So I want to deploy my reserve. Not yet. I think those tigers will work it out. It's three tigers. Yeah, we can attack those guys because you see this here, there is an elevation change. We want to do with those platoons. I think we want to keep them. Could of course advance the three line, but that might expose them too hard. Let's rather funnel the enemy force. Yeah, you want to funnel them, which is definitely happening here. If you would advance, we would take the entire brunt of this force here. Tiger's retreating. Did we lose a tiger? No. I think otherwise a wreck would be displayed on the map. So it's okay. I have those tigers retreat. It's fine. And I think those tigers attacking. Jimmy! I guess this captain riding a jeep. Okay, yeah, also E-34s might go here. Question. We don't blow up. We have some tank support here, but we definitely don't have some tank support here. I might apply my reserve Panzerkampfwagen 4 into this area. Because I see a danger here of T-34s attempting to break through. Tiger. Get into proper cover. Fight. Oh, Jimmy, I pressed the wrong button. Oh. No, not. Oh, damn it. That's a screw up. Can I reload? I screwed up. Some 75 mics. Seems like infantry is massing up here. Give them some 75 mic. Do not much, but if they, in case they don't move out. But that was a screw up here. I don't know. We might lose our tigers. Yes, no, no, yes. Jimmy! Should we change of plans? Seems like Zora is not breaking through here. But we have a serious problem here in the northeastern. Tiger, can you locate? No, those guys didn't climb the elevation. But we have some infantry here. Platoon engage. Good, Tiger's ready to defend. Here everything looks fine. We have a platoon, but that is suicide. Rather get out of sight. Semi-5, Mike, fire on that tree line. Well, is that off map 75 or is it all in? I guess that is off. Jimmy, microphone was disabled, yeah, happens. Probably communication lines severed, but we are back online. Oh, but those Tigers should take care of those guys, of this T-34 platoon. Okay, machine gun suppressing or... Oh! The T-34 moving up our positions. The Pack 75 should be in effective fire range. Dude, what is the Tiger doing? Hey. Pack fire. Good hits. Pack fire on that armored vehicle. One vehicle destroyed. Reaction fire. Again. Another vehicle destroyed. Good job. Tiger, what the heck? Why are you retreating? And Jimmy's rifle platoon, get back into your position. Dig in. Good, and Tigers, because he was being tested on the eastern front. There's three T-34s coming up. I need you here. Can you engage? Oh yeah. Missed. Nah, destroyed. Another destroyed. Good job. We lost visual on that platoon here. If they fall into our flank, we might have trouble. I need to roll up with the Tigers. No visual gained. Visual. Boah, Tony, yeah. Attack the rear vehicle. Vehicle destroyed. Three left. One left. Two left. That's. Tiger platoon might be endangered, but that was important. Otherwise, if those guys fall into our rear, we might crumble here. Where's the Panzerkampfwagen 4? Panzerkampfwagen 4 assist the Tiger. Reaction fire. How many Panzerkampfwagen 4 is it? Good, those guys are retreating. Tigers, eliminate those tanks. They're retreating. Nice! Push on them. Oh wait, we have... Julie, we have three T-34s in the south. Engage. Nice. One T-34 eliminated. Hello. T-34, I guess eliminated. Reaction fire, AT gun ready to fire. Another T-34 eliminated. To me, there's quite a lot of those guys in the open. Engage them. Still didn't take any casualties. No casualties taken. Prep up the half track. Zonakaft Z-11s are not capable of firing. Retreat. Okay, those guys are retreating. Good job. Left, from our perspective, right flank looking good. Center is still center and left is somewhat challenged, but nothing we can handle. Jimmy, can you get rid of Captain? Yeah, get rid of the Tony. Ah, okay, they can only see those. Yeah, fire on them. 50 Mike HE. Would definitely leave some impression. Good defense looks solid. I think the Soviets will not manage a breakthrough here. Check RT dialogue. We have some indirect 75 Mike. Let's fire that on this spot. I must say, I absolutely enjoy the soundtrack of this game. It has character. Yeah, you have currently here some people killing each other on the battlefield while listening to some rather uplifting war tunes. This discrepancy it is fitting often well, yeah. One of my favorite movies is here Iron Cross, where the intro is also coming with some uplifting military traditional music, but shows those rather gruesome pictures of World War II and yeah, the murdering or killing of human beings. For some reason that is fitting together and creating some character of gaming, or give a certain game a character, and that is basically here happening as well. We hear some uplifting tunes. Heroic tunes, while on the virtual tactical battle space, things are blowing up, things are dying. Yeah, good, okay, confirmed. Yeah, those Sonderkfz 11, they are absolutely worth nothing. Let's retreat them. Good, we have a Tiger here. Engage that T-34. Eliminate it. Good job. Before we move the Tiger, let's see. We have a group of two T-34s. And three Panzerkampfwagen 4 Friedrich 2. Can they handle those? Yeah, they can handle them. Jimmy's can handle them. Good. Bring that T-3. Wait, there's an elevation change here. I don't know if you can hit the tree line, that would be good. Three Tigers rolling hard. Nah, not. I was already expecting that. And we have a KV-1 heavy tank rolling up right in face of us. Blow it up. KV-1's retreating, but still on the same plane. Blow it up. I missed. Okay. But those KV-1's probably... There's two KV-1's left. Morale 7, defense 12. Yeah. We'll handle them. Let's first engage those infantry targets here. Prevent them from capturing our tree line. How much? 4. There was Papa Chartonis. Left flank is looking safe. Yeah, those Tigers definitely made the difference. Oh, we have a T-34 here. I didn't see that. But they didn't match anything. Good, 8 gun fire on that T-34. The T-34 responding. Fire again. T-34 retreating. Tiger, give it a rear shot. Mist. Come on. Mist. Good, but those guys are retreating. That is good news. Okay, first SMG platoon is disrupted. Okay, those guys were good job. Jimmy, I love Iron Cross, need to be issued here. Time limit reached. Allied major defeat. We worked it out, yeah. Pretty good defense. And yeah, those Tigers, experimental Tigers, definitely proved their value. Stopping those tank breakthroughs. And yeah, that was East Front 2. Still a pretty good game by modern standards. Very fun. And yeah, see you in the next episode. Good hunting.